and the defendant is discharged.
Officer Michael Brillo was found not guilty on Saturday in connection with his role in the deaths of two unarmed people at the end of a highly controversial 2012 police chase. While there were arrests over the weekend, most of the protests remained peaceful. Amen. The city still has to see how the entire legal process plays out regarding police officers' conduct in the Tanisha Anderson case, a mentally ill woman who died after police restrained her. And a grand jury will likely decide if any officers should be charged in the death of 12-year-old Tamir Rice, who police shot and killed after mistaking his airsoft pistol for a real gun. As we reported last year, Cincinnati implemented many of the changes to policing now being proposed for Cleveland, but only did so after widespread unrest.
What, in your judgment, might help make Cleveland different, that we stay peaceful while we implement all these reforms?
It's based on what the police, the chief said. It is how we as a community behave. Is a defining moment for us.
Mayor Frank Jackson says he respects the protesters and that people should see that the agreement with the Justice Department is a sign that the city is serious about police reform.
It is who we are as a city. And as we move forward, and we move forward, whether it's the things that are pending before us, the challenges, or new things that will arise, we believe that this agreement will help us work through things in a way that the community believes that they are truly being heard.
Officials caution the agreement should not be seen as a magic bullet.
Test of, meeting the promise of this agreement, it can't be and it shouldn't be perfection because people aren't perfect. Okay, the test is whether the systems are in place to minimize the chances of that occurring.
And for all its nuts and bolts, the agreement is really aimed at improving the relationship and the respect between the police and the community.
I have to, as chief, make sure that community policing philosophy is part of the DNA of the Cleveland Division of Police. And that's what I intend to do.
The chief added then the agreement is important for everyone, but mostly for the city's children and their futures. Bill Scheel, Fox 8 News.